Well, the only effect I use is reverb, but
reverb's nice.
Reverb,
it's a good
comes
one.
Through this.
Oh, cool.
The idea is this line out box goes between the amp and this dry cabinet here.
Okay.
And so it basically you just take the speaker out and go into this, and then it's got a speaker through that goes to this cabinet. Then this is actually a line out signal that goes into this volume pedal right here.
Okay.
That volume pedal goes to this Eventide space unit, and then that's a stereo unit that goes to stereo into this power amp, which goes to this cabinet in stereo. And these two speakers are one side, these two speakers are the other side.
Cool.
And it's purely wet coming through this side here. So, you know, the idea is, you know, it's really dry, you know. You know, and you can bring in wet through this side, you know. So if you want a lot, you know, side.
Cool.
I manipulate it sometimes, you know, and have a little bit or a lot, or sometimes none, depending on what you want. And that controls.
And you use the volume pedals to basically balance the two speaker cabinets and units?
Yeah. Yeah. And then this volume pedal here is just straight from my guitar into the volume pedal.
Okay.
And then that volume pedal's, so my guitar goes here, and then that goes to the Hughes and Kettner tube factor. That's really the only pedal I use, other than the volume pedal. And this is just a remote switch for the Hughes and Kettner, you know. You can hear it get hissy. And then on this side, just wetness. But, I mean, you know, you can hear. With this on, you know. The idea is to, you know, have more sustained stuff with the overdrive box.
Yeah, and it's an incredibly rich sound, too.
Thank you.
Both of them are.
Thank you.
Really amazing.
Oh, man, thanks. The speakers in this cabinet are Tone Tubby ceramic speakers.
Okay.
You know, 40 watt, they call them 40 for 40 or 40 40s or whatever.
Okay.
And I've had them for decades. John Harrison was a good friend of mine, and I got. And this old Sound City cabinet, I just put them in there, you know, because I like these old cabinets. And that has EV forces in it.
Okay.
Yeah. And they're wired in stereo through the arm.
Cool.
We found some EV forces. I like the EVs a lot.
And right behind you, you've got a bass monitor, right? That's what the Ampeg is?
Yeah. This is, I can just control how loud Dave is.
Cool.
From this, I mean, not how loud he is. Some people misunderstand. This only affects what I hear.
Yes.
Not what they hear.
You can't turn Dave down from over here.
No, no. only from this position of what I hear. I've gotten kind of nasty messages from people about me controlling the other band members' mixes, which of course it's only from my ears. And
yes.
That's what that's all about.
Yes.
Yeah, so I can turn Dave up or down. I can EQ it if I need to, but I never do. I just leave it like Joel sets it and just turn it up or down.
Cool. Know. And while we're talking about that, obviously here, here is where you do control all the other band members' mixes, at least just for yourself.
Right.
You've got a pedal board down here with volume pedals, and basically you've got everybody's signal going in here.
Yeah, what this was all about was is just being able to, I'm not very good at trying to convey, you know, what I need to the monitor engineer.
Mm-hmm.
When I'm trying to play. And I'm not a singer, so, you know, I think the singer's need is undivided attention, you know. And even though he's like, man, we don't have to do this, I'll do what you need. And he would, because he's one of the best in the business. But this just makes my life simpler. Like, if I need drums, I step on this volume pedal, a little bit more, a little bit less, whatever I need, percussion. Keyboards, and the B3 has its own wedge because it's such a rich, you know, thing. It needs its own wedge, you know, so it, you know.
Yes.
So it's clear, you know. Of course, I am pretty close to him, but.
You are pretty
close. If I need him, you know, I'll just do that.
Yep.
You know. And then this is JB's voice, you know, vocal. This is his guitar. so I can have more or less of his guitar or vocal. And the keyboards are the clavinet, the piano, and the Wurlitzer.
And how long have you had this rig? Which is a great idea.
Well, it started in 2000 when I was playing with the Dead, and you know, finding myself for the first time, sort of, on some of these big stages, and being completely out of my element and completely uncomfortable with how disconnected I felt on a giant stage from the rest of the group. And so I was talking to Dennis Leonard, the sound engineer. We call him Wiz because he's a wizard, you know. But Wiz, I was talking to him, and I was like, man, you think you could rig up something where I could control my own mix from volume pedals? Because that way I wouldn't have to stop and turn a knob like you do in a studio where you have that thing sitting on a tripod.
Yeah, a monitor, a control.
You know, your headphone amp or whatever you call it. But, you know, and he went, yeah, we could do that. Never done that before. And I was like, well, I mean, it would just make my life easier because, you know, I'd be able to not have to, you know, get your attention to do whatever I need, which I'm no good at conveying that if I'm in the music. I'd have to stop playing to clearly say.
Yeah, you want to keep your head in the right space.
Yeah. And this keeps me from having to think about anything, you know? And I'm used to stepping on a volume pedal. I've been standing on one for most of my life, so.